Mary, and I'm a senior at Harvard College. I study computer science and philosophy, and this is my friend Nick.
Hi, I'm Nick. I just graduated from Harvard, class of 2020, and I studied biomedical engineering and computer science. And today, we're here to talk to you about what we wish we knew as freshmen. Imposter syndrome is real. Everyone will tell you that you'll pretend as if you understand it, but what does that really mean? Great question. What I'm here to tell you is that you do not need to prove yourself. And that's kind of an important lesson that is really hard to get when you're coming into Harvard, because all you will feel is the need to prove yourself. You don't. It will come with time. Be patient. Be kind to yourself. You don't need to prove yourself.
Make the curriculum work for you. You don't have to take the exact same curriculum as everyone else. So for example, with computer science, the actual required curriculum is really short. It's only 10 classes, and so every class can feel like such a jump. And so for me, I took in-between classes to pad out that curriculum to make it, you know, a bit easier on me, and that was a really excellent thing. And if you have other interests in other departments or other schools, go and, you know, cross-register and try them out. So for example, I cross-registered 3 times at MIT, I cross-registered 2 times at Harvard Business School, I've taken classes in philosophy and history, and all of these departments that rounded out a curriculum that essentially personalized it just for my interests.
Take some time to go study abroad. When else in your life are you going to have the chance to uproot all of your life and with very few responsibilities or consequences go to a new country and continue to learn things and do as you do? It's a great experience. Several of my roommates did it and had a great time. I wish that I had, and I am now imparting that wisdom onto you.
Ask upperclassmen for advice. They are essentially one of your best resources because, you know, professors and advisors, they are wonderful, but they're often like, you know, the last time they were in your shoes was like kind of a long time ago. But for a lot of upperclassmen, the last time they were in your shoes was last semester or last year. So they are super intimately familiar with the problems you're having, and they are just a fantastic resource to get you caught up with what they know now.
Take classes based on your professors. You have all these requirements and all of this material you have to cover, and that's great, but if you're learning material from a professor that you just don't jive with, you're not gonna have a great time. Go find cool professors, listen to the cue guides, you'll end up enjoying your experience a lot more. You'll learn a lot too.
Get involved with the community. I have found over, you know, 4 years of college that the people who are most satisfied with their college experience, with their department, with their degree, are people who just invested a lot in the community and they got a lot back. You'll find that, like, at the end of everything, you are not going to remember the nights you spent, you know, doing homework or kind of doing classic things. You will remember the people and the relationships you had, and a lot of that comes from just investing in the community and really being involved.